Hello and welcome back. In the previous tutorial, we created an abstract WSDL file based on an earlier created XML schema, and then we started to create our composite service. We created an empty Beeple process which exposes the public web service interface based on the abstract WSDL file which we just created. In our kind of an example creation, we are currently creating this composite service. We have a mockup for reservation system and we have a wrapper for running sales scripts. But we still don't have an actions table. So let's change a little bit focus and next create this table so we have a list of actions to take whenever we receive a GeoFence event and this status of the car is not known. So let's go back to SQL developer and start it. All right, so let's go to this simple. Now it's connecting to database. And we should have only one table, this vehicle status. So let's add a new table here. Right click on tables, new table. And let's call this, for example, SEO action. Put some columns here, like first one could be an ID, this could be a number, then we could have something like this. This could be a primary key and not now. We could have a location ID. So the idea here is that for different locations the set of actions could be different, so you don't have to. And that could be a varchar. Let's make it 32. It could be perhaps. Let's make it a not null. Let's add an other column. Call this one, for example, script. This will be the abstract name for the script to run. Let's make that one. For example, 64 should not be null. So next column, let's call this one, for example, priority. And this one could also be number. Let's get advanced mode. Sorry. Let's add still some columns here. So that's another one. Let's call this one, for example. Let's add a couple of parameters. So in a final kind of productized version, you probably wouldn't want to. Just the hard code, the number of parameters, but this is a tutorial, so let's give another one. You might have an additional, like, helper table where you have the parameters and then you could do a join, but let's make this simple. So now I have a table that looks like this, says ID. This will be a unique or primary key. And I will generate these IDs from a sequence. There's location ID. Okay, so it should be location ID. Not location OD. Let's change that one. And then there's a script, which will be the script to run priority, which would enable us to set in what order we run these scripts and then a couple of parameters just to kind of have a little bit of a flexibility here. Not really something you would like to do in the final definition. All right. Next, we want to create an. We would like to create an open SQL worksheet from here. I would like to create an index, I would like to create a sequence and then base this ID automatically from the sequence. So let's give this commands directly from here. Create sequence. Let's call this, for example, action sequence start with one. Let's execute this one. Okay, and then create a trigger. So this is based on the insert into the CL action table. I think that's it. Do I still need to say end? Probably yes. Okay, this one creates a trigger into the database. Okay, a trigger created. Now we can go on. Start to put some data into the database table. So let's we don't need to put anything to the ID because it will be populated automatically. Let's give some location. Script priority could be one, params would be A and B. And then let's try to save this. Alright. So even our sequence is working. So now what we did here is that we created a sequence, which kind of an easy way in database to say that generate me automatically, kind of consecutively increasing numbers. I mean, I think you can also in sequences give the kind of a program how it kind of generates these numbers. You could say that. Always kind of, what is the increment and so on. Then I created a trigger, which automatically, whenever I insert a row into this table, it runs this little piece of code, and this one basically creates the next value from the sequence, and it replaces the ID value with the number coming from the sequence. So this is how I don't have to worry about the ID field, but whenever I just insert something into the database, the trigger will automatically generate that ID for me. So now we have defined this geoaction table, and we are ready to proceed to the next phase. So, and in that phase, we will be returning to our composite service and start to use all of these features like the mockup reservation system, database, geoaction database, and then also this shell script wrapper. But that's the focus for the next tutorial, so thanks for watching and see you in the next tutorial.